Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you want to see how I went from this to this in the spirit of Halloween, please keep on watching. First thing I gotta do is shave. Ugh, not very cute, but you know, it'll do. I got me a drink and I'm good to go. So the first thing here I'm doing is just wiping my brows and with some alcohol to get rid of any oil. And then I am brushing them through. I'm gonna glue them down with a Elmer's School Glue Stick in the purple shade so I know when it's dry. So I'm just putting the glue in downward so that when I comb them up, they will lay nice and flat when I cover them. And then I'm giving them a comb up to get the process started. Then I'm going over again and laying the glue over top with my brows brushed upward to get them nice and flat. And then I'm going over top with a spoon to smooth it over. And I'm doing that on both brows, obvi. And then I'm hitting them with a blast of cold air from my blow dryer. It's just gonna help to set the glue a little bit faster so that I can get to covering them up. I'm gonna do this a few times, and then once that's done, I'm covering it up with some translucent powder just to take any remaining stickiness away and fill in any gaps in between the hair that is still a little bit bumpy because we want it to be as smooth as possible. Once that's done, I'm going over it with some full coverage foundation from MAC. This is a nice heavy cream foundation that really covers well. I'm pressing that over top with a foundation brush, and the shade in this is NC45. Then once the other brow is covered, I start blending it up my forehead just so that I can have one uniform color all over. I also carry this down my cheeks, and this is the foundation that I use as my base all over. Then once I have a nice even layer of that all over my face, I go over it with a Miracle Complexion sponge from Real Techniques, just to make sure there's no streakiness and it's a nice smooth finish all over, making sure that everything's all blended from the ears, down the jaw, eyelids, everything. Obviously, I have to stop and take a selfie because I look crazy. Then once that's done, I go over top of my brows with more Coty Airspun Translucent Powder just to make sure everything's all set so when we go to start eyeshadow, we are good. And then I move on to concealer. So I'm using my LA Girl Cosmetics Pro Conceal, I believe it's called. The color in this one is Pure Beige. So I'm using that to highlight my under eye, the Cupid's Bow, my chin, tip of my nose, that kind of stuff, you know. Then I'm just going back over the concealer with a damp sponge this time just to press it into the skin, make it nice and smooth. So then once we are all blended in, I'm going back over my under eye and any areas where I did my highlighting and concealing. With more translucent powder, I'm just going to kind of bake these areas, get it really nice and matte. And then once that's set, I'm going to go into cream contour. So I'm using this cream color from MAC called Copper Beach. And I'm buffing that into my hollows of my cheeks, my temples, jawline. I'm just doing this to add some depth to my face, make it look a little bit more feminine, pronounce my cheekbones a little bit more, sharpen up my jawline. You know the drill. And I'm using a Real Techniques duo fiber brush just to buff that in so it's really nice and soft, but we still get lots of depth of color. I'm also taking that cream color contour and just running it down the sides of my nose. What I'm trying to do here is achieve a more narrow bridge of my nose. Again, it's just going to help my face look a little bit softer and more feminine that way. And I'm also carrying that up just into the inner corner of my brow bone, so it creates the illusion of a bit of a higher crease as well. And then naturally, you know, you gotta do your caramel Voldemort dance. So now what I'm doing is just setting the rest of my face with some translucent powder on a big fluffy powder brush. Using such a heavy cream foundation, you need to make sure that everything's really nice and dried out before you go in with any powder products. Otherwise, you're gonna get weird buckling or skipping if you try and go right over it. So I'm just going over top and making sure everything is really nice and set in place. And then after, what I'm doing is going over top with a powder foundation, so Studio Fix powder in the color NC42, just to, you know, take the ash soot look away. Then I'm going back over top of my cream contour with powder this time. Again, I'm using a Studio Fix powder. This color is NW58, and I'm putting that right over top of where I put my cream color. Just putting the translucent powder over top has kind of taken some of that depth away, so I'm re-intensifying it and just kind of layering my products so that it looks really dimensional. Then I'm going over top of it with bronzer just to warm it up a little bit. Again, I'm not trying to look gray. I'm using another Studio Fix powder, and this one's in the color NC47. It's lighter, but again, it has a little bit more warmth to it, so I don't look so dead. Now it's time for me to move into my brows. So this part is definitely challenging, but you gotta take your time. I'm using that same color I used for my bronzer, actually, because it's a nice warm medium brown. And I'm making a base shape, just kind of carving much higher than where my natural brow sits. But this is where I want the bottom line of the brow to be. So I'm starting here just to get like my base shape. And once I'm happy with that, I go along the top part of my brow now. And this is where I can sort of define the arch and how dramatic it's going to be. But I'm kind of flattening it out and then tapering off the shape at the end so that it's not too crazy. Like, it's a semi-believable brow. And once that's done, then I just start filling in between. And then you've got to move on to the other brow to make it match up. Once they're both filled in, I go in with a darker Studio Fix powder. Again, I'm going back over it with NW58. And I'm defining the bottom edge of the brow and adding sort of little hair strokes in the interior of the brow just to make it look a little bit more fluffy and textured. I carry those little hair strokes out to the very front of the brow as well. So that way it's not just sort of squared off at the front. And just kind of layering it and making more and more hair strokes as I go along and adding depth to different parts. Then the last bit that I do is add a little bit of Dip Brow, and this is like a gel brow cream from Anastasia Beverly Hills. The color is Ebony, and I go and make even darker little hair strokes, and then I just blend it with a small angle brush. Then I'm adding a little bit of concealer just underneath the brow to sharpen up that edge, make the brows look really sort of carved out and sharp, and add a little bit of a brow highlight as well. For that concealer, I'm just using the same one I used under my eyes, and then I blend it out. Then it's time to move on to eyes, which is definitely the most exciting part. So I'm starting off with my base as Liquid Lipstick, again from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I believe the shade is called Catherine, and it is like a mauvey, purpley pink color. So I just kind of paint it all over the lid and then blend it out in a sort of winged out shape on my upper lid. I went ahead and finished one eye off camera, just so we don't have to film both, but I'm adding some depth to my crease with a color called Love Letter from the Modern Renaissance palette, and then I'm adding a bit of brow highlight with a sort of bone beige color from MAC Cosmetics. I add that to my brow bone just to set the concealer and highlight, as well as the inner corner of my eye to open everything up. And then I'm adding a dazzle shadow, and this one's from the Kabuki Magic palette from MAC Cosmetics, but this color is called Last Dance, and it's a permanent shade that you can always get from the stores. It's like a nice pinky glitter, and I'm layering that right over top of that liquid lipstick and the Love Letter shadow. I'm taking the shimmering white one from that palette as well. This was a limited edition shade, but I'm putting that in the inner corner and then just buffing it in with a brush and layering it up so it's nice and intense. Then I'm taking that same Love Letter color that I put in my crease, and I'm wrapping that around the lower lash line as well, just to add a little bit of depth down there, but not too much. I add a little bit of an off-white pencil. This one's called Pale Yellow, again from MAC Cosmetics, just to my waterline to make my eyes look a bit bigger. And I add a little bit more depth to my lower lash line and my inner waterline as well. You can also see I added some lashes. And now what I'm doing here is wiping away that baking powder so it's nice and seamless. And then I add a bit of cheek color as well. So this is a Tarte Amazonian Clay foundation. I think the color is called Party. It is like a soft pinky color. I go in and add cheek highlight. You guys know that's my favorite part. Using the Nicole Guerrero palette, the color Kitty Cat, as well as one from MAC called Gold Deposit. Here what I'm doing is adding some faux freckles. Again, I just want to do this to add some dimension to my face, make it look not so intense, and make it look a little bit more like skin. You know, if it could be a little bit believable, I would love that. And then I'm adding my highlight to my cupid's bow and chin. I put some of my brow as well, and now we're going to move on to lips. So the vibe for this whole sort of look for me was very like early 2000s R&B star, you know, with that muted brown, nude glossy lips. I'm starting with Cork lip pencil and overlining just, you know, touch, just to give my lips some definition and manipulate the shape a little bit as well. Then I'm adding a lipstick from MAC Cosmetics called The Right Note from the Nicki Minaj and MAC collection. It's like a nice glossy creamy nude color, and I'm blending that into the lip pencil, and then after I go over it with my fave Myth lip gloss. It's a light nude color, just to add gloss and a little bit of lighter color. Just go around the edge with a lip brush just to blend all the products together, and we are done. So boom. Anyway, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was so much fun for me to make. And in the spirit of Halloween, have some fun. You know, it's just makeup. Anyway, until next time, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.